बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम रब्बि इशरह ली सदरी वयस्सिर ली अमरी वाहलुल उक़दतम मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हु क़ौली रब्बि ज़िदनी इल्मा। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी आर हियर विद लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ फिजिक्स एंड द टॉपिक इज रोलिंग फ्रिक्शन। एज यू आर फेमिलियर ऑफ द टर्म फ्रिक्शन, फ्रिक्शन मीन्स द फोर्स ऑफ ऑपोजिशन विच कम्स इन टू एक्शन वेन वन ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूव्ड ओवर द सर्फेस ऑफ एन अदर ऑब्जेक्ट। वॉट इज रोलिंग? Rolling is that kind of movement in which one object rotates and it also moves in the forward direction. Now, what is then rolling friction? Rolling friction is that friction which comes into action when one object rolls over the surface of another object. For example, wheel is the very first simple machine invented by mankind, and it rolls rather than to slide. When the axle of the wheel is pushed, friction comes into action, providing reaction force opposite to the applied force. Look at this figure. We have a wheel and road, and this is the point of contact between the wheel and the road. When the wheel moves, the friction at this point of contact comes into action, and this friction force provides a reaction force opposite to the applied force, which is responsible for the movement of the wheel. As we read in our previous lecture that every surface has pits and bumps on its surface, so this wheel has too. The road has also pits and bumps. When the wheel is placed on the road, the pits and bumps of these two are interlocked. But when the wheel moves forward, these pits and bumps, the locking connection or the cold weld, is again ruptured. At the next point, again another cold weld is formed, and in this way the cold welds are formed for a very short time and the wheel moves step by step. The reaction force is responsible for the wheel to move. Now what happens to the cold welds? Cold welds is the structure like this in which the pits and bumps of one surface are interlocked with the pits and bumps of another surface. The shape of the wheel is such that it moves without rupturing the cold welds due to small contact area. Without rupturing means that the cold welds are not pressed for a very long time. A cold weld is formed and removed again and again. Therefore, rolling friction is less than the sliding friction. And this principle of rolling friction is also applied in ball bearings and roller bearings. What are ball bearings? As you see in the bicycle, we have ball bearings which convert the sliding friction into rolling friction, and this is responsible for the wheel to move. What would happen if there was no friction between the wheel and the road? The wheel would slip by pushing its axle. Yes, the wheel would slip if there was no force of friction. How we are going to increase this force of friction between the tire and the road? Actually, the tire has a threading over its surface. What do we mean by threading? Threading means this structure, any design found on the surface of the tire, which is responsible to increase the force of friction between the tire and the road. It increases the gripping power of the tire with the road. How a cyclist stops the bicycle? When brakes are applied, the pits and bumps or the threading on the tires get locked. With the pits and bumps of the road, the pressing force on the tire is increased, and this locking connection stops the bicycle. Now your today's homework is you have to write down the question, define rolling friction, and you will get the answer from here. How sliding friction helps to move a wheel? You will get the answer from here. What would happen if there was no rolling friction? And here is the answer. Okay, you will read page number 74 and you will write the answer in another proper way. Next question is, what would happen if there was no rolling friction? And the fourth question is, what happens when brakes are applied? And you are going to write down this answer on your notebook. Thank you, class. Assalamu alaikum. This is the structure like this in which the pits and bumps of one surface are interlocked with the pits and bumps of another surface. The shape of the wheel is such that it moves without rupturing the cold welds due to small contact area. Without rupturing means that the cold welds are not pressed for a very long time. A cold weld is formed and removed again and again. Therefore, rolling friction is less than the sliding friction. And this principle of rolling friction is also applied in ball bearings and roller bearings. What are ball bearings? As you see in the bicycle, we have ball bearings which convert the sliding friction into rolling friction, and this is responsible for the wheel to move. What would happen if there was no friction between the wheel and the road? The wheel would slip by pushing its axle. Yes, the wheel would slip if there was no force of friction. How we are going to increase this force of friction between the tire and the road? Actually, the tire has a threading over its surface. What do we mean by threading? Threading means this structure, any design found on the surface of the tire, which is responsible to increase the force of friction between the tire and the road. It increases the gripping power of the tire with the road. How a cyclist stops the bicycle? When brakes are applied, the pits and bumps or the threading on the tires get locked with the pits and bumps of the road. The pressing force on the tire is increased and this locking connection stops the bicycle. Now your today's homework is you have to write down the question, define rolling friction, and you will get the answer from here. How sliding friction helps to move a wheel? You will get the answer from here. What would happen if there was no rolling friction? And here is the answer. Okay. You will read page number 74 and you will write the answer in another proper way. Next question is, what would happen if there was no rolling friction? And the fourth question is, what happens when brakes are applied? And you are going to write down this answer on your notebook. Thank you, class. Assalamu alaikum.